Yes, a possibility of a seven-way tie. We're not worried about that at this point in time. Very, very thankful to play an epic Penn-Princeton battle on this past weekend. And started out, you know, and our mindset was to slow down an offense that's very, very explosive. Three times this year, they've scored over 50 points. And we just went through Harvard a couple weeks back, and it looked like there was different speed out there. And of course, Princeton takes the ball right down the field and scores on the first drive. I'm like, okay, here we go. But after that point in time, our offense matched it and did a great job of ball controlling. Our mindset was to slow it down, and we had time of possession over 13 minutes more than they did on the day. Went at the halftime up with a comfortable lead, 17-7, but nothing's ever comfortable. Came out of the second half, and we took the opening drive down 80 yards to score a touchdown. We had two running backs who had rushed for over 100 yards, Abe Willows and Trey both did. We wanted to control the ball, which we did. And then that's where things began to come apart with a miss hit on by our punter, maybe a 12-yard punt, two fumbles before you blinked an eye. They were leading it ahead. And now the avalanche was starting to fall again. Kids settled up and got some composure late in the game. I thought our quarterback, Will Fisher Colby, our senior, again, his first time playing after all this reps, really did a nice job. All-American Justin Watson had two touchdowns, and he threw three beautiful balls to win it. On our final drive, we took it 80 yards, being down by 4 points, and to score. They got the ball back with a minute and 30, and that was when the game just began. They took the ball down. We make an interception on first down and 20 play, only for our cornerback to line offsides. They got another shot at it, moved down the field, and with, I guess it was 10 seconds ago, threw a fade to the back of the end zone. Initially, it was called a touchdown, got overruled. Okay, we got that. So it was only 7 seconds ago in the game. It was third down. They decided to kick the field goal, and they went wide right. So we won it all 59 minutes and 57 seconds in the game. It took us to get down the win. So really proud of the kids just in terms of how they battled all year long. It was like, whoa, here it happens again. They stuck to it. Great energy, great crowd, 10,000 people, alumni, everybody back. So that was great to get a win there. And you never know what's going to happen this year in our league. It's been up and down. Our motto has always been play meaningful games in November. And once again, we'll head up to Harvard playing a meaningful game there. They too have had some ups and downs and some quarterback woes. It seems like that's the theme this year of some stability at that position. So they are looking for some answers on both sides there. We go in, and they obviously excited to take the trip up to Cambridge. And our guys know what's at stake, but the most important thing at stake is, you know, get that third win in a row, get this, you know, the troops moving in the right direction. And we come out of the game actually probably healthier than we went in. So that's a good sign on a lot of fronts. But any questions?
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago, your kids are out here, and now I know it's mathematically on. Does it give them like a little bit more of a lift to know that, you know, they're not only playing to have a winning season or be Harvard, but that maybe, you know, if they do what they do, they have a shot?
Sure. I mean, again, it's always a carrot, right? That's a great carrot to have out there. But, you know, Mark said it earlier. If you build it differently, the kids come to play all the time, right? You have good kids, good foundation. You know, even though we were, quote unquote, out of it, they just knew how close we were and all along and should have, could have. I sat in this room, you know, 2 weeks ago and said, if you want this, might have mentioned this last week, if you want to continue to say two or three plays we could have, that means you got to win the rest. Because then you can't say that anymore. I think the, you know, pretty smart kids took that to heart and said, let's make a statement. And they continue. So, yes, our practice, you know, yesterday in the rain was as upbeat as you can have it, 35 degrees and in the rain, and, you know, getting after it. And I think they're all focused and dialed in, even because, you know, again, they're smart kids. They know they got a shot for something, and it's something to play for. And again, as we go into these games, you know, Princeton's, you know, great rival tradition, and so is Harvard. There's no love lost between our schools, because I would say in the last, you know, probably 30 years, it's been, you know, one of us have been battling out, duking it out for a piece of it.